Yes. Dear students, welcome to BISEC video lecture series for the subject Elements of Civil Engineering. Myself, Reina Shukla, Associate Professor, Civil Engineering Department, LD College of Engineering. As per the syllabus of Gujarat Technological University, in Module 6, that is Transportation Engineering, which is defined for 5 hours for teaching, and it will be concluded in 5 lecture series. Today, in this second lecture, we are studying about modes of transportation, that is waterways and airways. In the previous lecture, we have discussed main 2 important modes of transportation. Those are the transportation on land, roadways and railways. Waterways and airways are the part of today's session. Waterways, that is the transportation, movement of goods and passengers, is carried out through waterways. If we are seeing the advantages of waterways, then it is the cheapest mode of transportation as it is working on natural path. There is no construction cost as such in roadway and preparation of railway track. It is the natural path of water available which is used as one mode of transportation. It possesses high load carrying capacity. The freight which we can transport through waterways is high in volume, high in quantity, and it is economical mode of transportation because the fuel consumption for those materials transportation is comparatively very low. Bulky and heavy goods like plants and machineries can be easily transported through waterways. As it's a natural path, there is less maintenance cost. It promotes commerce, industries, and international trade. The transportation from one nation to another nation is easily, cheaply, economically carried out by waterways. It is a mean of defense in emergency. The equipments, machineries, weapons can easily be transported through waterways. As in roadways and railways have certain limitations, same way waterways have also certain limitations. It is the slowest mode of transportation. If you are looking towards the distance to be transported and the time it is taking for transportation, it is the slowest mode of transportation. It takes longer routes because it provides the connectivity where the water is available as natural path. So routes are longer. It works on fixed routes only. Where navigable water is available, there only connectivity is provided. It depends on feeder system for distribution and collection of goods and passengers. The trucks are required as feeder system through roadways. Goods train is required as feeder system for movement of the goods from markets or from the industries to the location from where it will be transported through waterways. Storm, hurricane, like natural calamities, cause severe accidents and loss of goods and passengers. It's a great loss. Sometimes even passengers' dead body is not available and goods at all not available back. High tides seriously affects loading and unloading of the cargo in the vessels which are transporting them through waterways. Thus, we have seen advantages and limitations of waterways. The fourth mode of transportation, that is airways. As a mode of transportation, what are its advantages? It is the fastest mode of transportation. It is very useful in transporting goods and passengers to the area which are not accessible by any other means. The remote area, the areas in mountainous region, hilly areas, where the climatic condition is adverse. Those are the locations which are not easily accessible by any another mode of transportation. Then airways are there to provide transportation, to send different commodities as per the demand. Goods transportation is possible. It is the most convenient mode of transportation during natural calamities like flood. At the time of flood, to send drinking water, food packets, medicines is easy through aircrafts, through helicopters, that is through airways. Where any another mode cannot be helpful because the land is submerged in water. Railway tracks are not of the use. Roadways are also affected by the heavy flood water. Then airways will be helpful. Even rescue to the people who are affected in flood can be possible through airways. It provides vital support to the national security and defense. It provides continuous journey over long distance. Long distance transportation from one nation to another nation is easy through airways. It can fly over both land and water. Any another mode is not such that which can work on land as well as on water. Airways do not require any artificial track. As such, in waterway, there is natural water path. Here, there is natural airways which need not for any track preparation. It is used for aerial photography to make different maps, maps of topography, maps of contours, maps of the area having the crop. So, different photography is possible through aerial photography by airways. So these are the advantages of airways. Now we see certain limitations or disadvantages of the airways. We can say it is expensive mode of transportation. Cost of transportation is more. Initial operation and maintenance cost is high. As we have to make airports, running of airports, operation. Same way, maintenance of different components of the airports. So its initial construction cost, operational cost, as well as maintenance cost is high. It is suitable for limited goods transportation. It is at all not suitable for transporting heavy and bulky goods. It is affected by adverse weather conditions like fog and heavy rainfall. Number of flights are cancelled, delayed due to the problem of visibility during fog and heavy rainfall. It is not suitable for short distance travel. For short distance travel, generally roadways are most convenient mode of transportation. In case of accidents, it results in heavy losses of goods, property and life. Compared to roadways, number of accidents we are observing less, but whenever accident occurs, it results in heavy loss of goods, property and life. So this way we have seen about advantages, disadvantages of waterways and airways. Now we see in detail about the waterways. So as I have told, waterway is efficient mode of transportation for cargo. So here you can see the large number of cars are transported through waterway. Waterway cargo transportation, high in volume, bulky, heavy in weight, are easily transported through waterway. As such, on roadway, we can move with our own desired vehicle. Even by walk, we are moving. Those vehicles are motorized, non-motorized vehicles. On waterway, the vehicles which are used are known as vessel, ship, steamer, boat, ferry, and submarine. Ferry, it is just like city bus service on roadways. On definite route, regularly, it makes trip. It is used for passenger transportation. The trip purpose can be regular purpose like education, employment, visit to market. The perishable goods like fish, vegetable, fruits are also transported through ferry. Flowers are also transported through ferry. So from the origin to the destination like market, through ferry it is transported. So ferry are the boats which are moving on regular path, defined connectivity, defined stops and scheduled one. High speed boats, motor boats. Ship, for large number of passenger transportation with cruise like luxurious facilities for entertainment, for transportation through waterway, large quantity of goods cargo is also transported. Submarine, generally they are floating below the water level at desired depth from the seabed. It is used by military also, and that is carried out for defense purpose also, for security purpose also. It is also part of the waterway vehicle. The ship which we are seeing here are showing its components. Those are generally described for the movement of vessels easily on the waves by following the natural phenomena like tides, the wind effects. Water transportation is carried out as inland water transportation and ocean water transportation. From one nation to another nation through the sea, even from one location to another location within the nation. Docks, harbor and port are like railway stations in case of railways. They are the location which provides connectivity for waterway transportation to the passengers and cargo supplier. India has large coastline of 5,770 km and Gujarat has coastline of 1,600 km. What is dock? Docks are sheltered basin for berthing ships. Dock facilitates loading and unloading of cargo. There are different types of dock: wet dock, dry dock, which is also known as gravity dock, repair dock, lift dock, and floating dock. The cargo which is not unloaded on platform and it is supposed to be emptied nearby dock area in the sea body, sea water, then floating docks are useful. Dry dock. So under the effect of gravity, the vessel is entering into the dry dock. Then by pumping, water is emptied out from the dock area. Then this way, in dry condition, the vessel is there. If they want to remove the rust corrosion, want to color, carry out some maintenance, then it is easy in the dry dock. What is port? Port is a harbor with necessary terminal facilities such as storage, landing of passengers and cargo. Every port is a harbor, but every harbor is not a port. As per the type of cargo which is transferred through waterways at a particular port, they are classified as grain port, coaling port, and transshipment port. As per the size and location, ports are classified as major port, intermediate port, and minor port. If we are looking towards the scenario of Gujarat, then Kandla is categorized as major port. Bedi, Magdalla near Surat, Dahej are categorized as intermediate port. Diu and Daman are categorized as minor port. In addition to all these ports, Gujarat having port at Bhavnagar, Navlakhi, Veravar, Okha, Porbandar, Sikka, Mandvi. So here in this map of Gujarat, you find different ports along with their geographical position. The business dealt by that particular port, the facilities provided at a particular port, the area provided at a particular port, as per that, they are categorized as major, intermediate, and minor port. Mumbai port, one of the big port of the India. Mundra port of Gujarat. As in definition of port, we have seen the word harbor. What is harbor? Harbor is a partly enclosed, protected water area to provide safe and suitable accommodation for vessels seeking supplies, refueling, repairs, transfer of goods, and refuge. Refuge means allow the ship or any vessel during storm-like emergency. Generally, any vessel visits any harbor as per the goods to be transported and required to be covered under the route or schedule. But in case of emergency, they are sheltered at a particular harbor. So they are known as refuge harbor. Harbors are classified as per protection needed, as per location, as per utility. There are three ways to classify the harbor. This is the layout of harbor. So you are finding different components and the operations which can be carried out at harbor. So basin is there, floating cranes are there for loading, unloading of the cargo. For the channelization, approach, water is channelized. Different berthing places are shown. Classification as per protection needed. There are three types: natural harbor, semi-natural harbor, artificial harbor. As per the natural phenomena existing at a particular location and existing scenario, if it is naturally suitable for harbor area, then it is considered as natural harbor. If on one side naturally available, on another side artificially available, it is semi-natural. And on both sides, artificial walls are prepared, that is artificial harbor. That also we are seeing when we are looking about breakwater. As per the location, at sea body, near river, even at canal or lake, these are the four types. As per the utility of that area, refuge harbor, commercial harbor, which is used for fishing, fishery harbor, which is used by military, that is military harbor. What are the components of harbor? So in sketch, previous figure, you have seen harbor with different components. So those components are namely quay, wharf, breakwater, piers, jetty, turning basin. These are the important components of harbor. What is quay? Quay is a platform parallel to the shore for berthing of vessels. It is a facility for loading and unloading of cargo. Loading and unloading of cargo. The platforms are provided with quay walls. Quay walls are the structures like retaining walls to protect the base. Base can be of embankment or in filling. The platforms are provided with quay walls to protect the base in quay. So here you can see parallel to the seashore, the quay has been made with the quay wall, retaining wall. What is wharf? The platforms in which wall-like structure, the platforms in the form of walls built near shore for vessels to berth are known as wharves. Number of boats you can see at the wharf. The platforms in the form of walls built near shore for vessels to berth are known as wharves. What is jetty? Jetties are the structures in the form of piled projection built out from the shore to deep water. Jetties are perpendicular to the shore, hence they are affected by wave action. Severe wave action may damage the jetties. Jetties have berth on one side or on both sides as per the demand of cargo transportation they can use. Jetties, you can see they are perpendicular structure to the shore. So they are the structures in the form of piled projection built out from the shore to the deep water. Breakwater. So as we have seen the classification, natural, semi-natural and artificial. So they are with the breakwater. Breakwater are a protective barrier to enclose harbor, to keep the harbor water undisturbed by the effect of strong and heavy sea, incoming waves and wind. Due to breakwater in the harbor area, we are finding more or less steady water. Generally, seawater is with waves, but by breakwater, we are breaking the waves. We are making them calm. And that water will only allow to prepare a basin on which various ships, boats can be harbored and loading, unloading and different activities can be carried out. So breakwater provides calm water for anchorage of ships. It is made of different components like core and armor. It is mainly of two types. Either it will be in the form of heap, that is known as the mound type, and second type, that is wall type. Both are made from the rubble stone, concrete block, patented stones. Whichever is locally easily available, those rubble stones are used. If locally not available, they are using concrete blocks. And certain definite designed stones, patented stones are also used to make heap of the stone or the wall of the stone, that is to make the breakwater. So this breakwater you can find here, this is wall type. This is with the rubble stones, with the concrete blocks and rubble stones, patented blocks. So here you are finding ship entering in the harbor. So these are the breakwater. So these are the structures constructed. So inside harbor area, basin water is steady or say calm water. Here is the sea with wave actions. So through this entrance, ship enters into the harbor area. So if these two walls, which is enclosing harbor area, is naturally available, they are natural harbor. If on one side naturally available and on another side artificially mound type or wall type breakwater is constructed, that is semi-natural, and on both side breakwater is constructed, that is artificial harbor. Dolphin. It is a component which is used for mooring the vessels. Mooring the vessels means tie up the ships. If we want to unload cargo from the ship, or if we want to transfer cargo from one ship to another ship, then we need dolphins. We need to tie up the ships. Dolphin is made by taking 7 piles and arrange them in hexagonal shape. And tie up them by cable or rope-like wires at a regular interval of distance as per the height of the dolphin. That is use as a post for tying up the ship. Piers are the structures which are built perpendicular or oblique to the seashore where sea is not deep. They are provided to support the floor, timber floor, concrete floor or RCC floor. It is provided with pile foundation, as it has to sustain the activities carried out on the floor. So piers are provided with pile foundation, raft foundation, step footing, and they are up to below the seabed. So they are supported by pile foundation and raft foundation and step footing. Masonry, concrete and RCC framed structures between seabed and bottom of floor. Lighthouse. It is a lofty structure built of masonry or reinforced concrete in the shape of tall tower on a high pedestal. Lighthouse at night time with the solid beam or ray of light. Mooring buoys. So as we have seen in previous picture that ship is entering through approach channel. So from the sea body, they are guided to the approach channel, and then only it is possible for safe and convenient entry of the vessel in harbor area. So floating buoys, mooring buoys are provided. So they are anchored at the bottom. At sea bed level, they are anchored, and through chain, they are in suspension in floating condition, but generally they are at the same location. They do not move from their position much more. They are with lighting to provide visibility from a distance during night time, after sunset, early morning. Some mooring buoys are provided with the concrete blocks provided at the bottom. The cargoes which are supposed to be loaded in a ship, then cargoes waiting on the dock or say port harbor, then they are provided in storage. The cargo which is unloaded from ship and different vessels are waiting from the trucks to fetch it and send it to desired industry or the market. So they are stored in the transit safes. They are stored in warehouses, which are the load-bearing structure, frame structures with roof coverings. In warehouses, grains transported are generally stored in warehouse. For loading, unloading of the cargo, they need different lifting machineries, equipments. cranes are mostly used for that. Rubber tires, stacking crane, movable cranes which lift the containers and send them to desired storage space, lifting of containers. Rail mounted cranes, these are also movable crane. Portal crane, generally from the ship the cargo is lifted directly through portal crane. The boom, length of boom is adjustable. At the waterway, when site selection is carried out, the site visit is supported by the ratings given by the Beaufort scale. Beaufort scale having 0 to 12 number, and it is indicating wind intensity, wind direction, wind speed. The speed that is measured in miles per hour. So if it is observed less than 1, it is considered the area is calm. And as we move from 0 to 12, we are finding wind speed is increasing. We are saying bridge. So bridge is in the range of 4 to 7 miles per hour to the 25 to 31 miles per hour speed and Beaufort scale number 1 to 7. We are finding storm comes. There is predictions for hurricane are carried out. So at that time, Beaufort scale number is 11, 12, and wind velocity, wind speed is observed more than 64 miles per hour. So at that time, alert signals are given for safety of the waterway vehicles, passengers, goods. So for safety indication, Beaufort scale is used. At the same time, for site selection also, past record as per the Beaufort scale is observed, and then design work is carried out. This is pictorial view of Beaufort scale effects. Here you are finding calamity, problems, heavy wind. So this we have seen about Beaufort scale, which is used for safety and site selection. So till this we have seen about waterway and their components. For waterway transportation, it is required to maintain the depth of water. For that, if there is silt settlement at the bottom, then it should be mechanically removed. So excavation of bed below water is carried out by dredger. It is regular maintenance work carried out at the harbor to maintain the sufficient water level. Ship requires some definite draft to move safely without any obstruction. Otherwise, that ship will not come out from the silt which has been concentrated. And the heavier loaded ship, if it will be in problem due to the delta, due to the silt concentration, then it is very difficult to shift it from that position. So dredging operation is carried out regularly. The waterways are maintained by maritime board. In Gujarat, there is Gujarat Maritime Board, which has established itself as maritime leader in port development, privatization, and specialized cargo handling in India. It is also the first maritime board of the country, which was created up in 1982 with a vision to enhance and harness ports and international trade as vehicles for economic development. Gujarat Maritime Board has effectively implemented a unique business model which has shown the pathway to growth and has successfully placed the non-major ports of Gujarat as benchmark for other states to follow. Now we see about the fourth mode of transportation, that is airways. Vehicles for airways are aeroplane, aircraft, helicopter, charter plane, Airbus. Components of aircraft. By study of the characteristics of aircraft, the design of airport, training of pilots, design of fuel and their wise consumption, design of different components of airport and aircraft is carried out. Transportation of goods and passengers through airways, that is aviation activity, that is carried out on airport, aerodrome, heliport and helipad. Large size airport. Heathrow Airport. Airport in UAE. Heliport or helipad are the small space required for landing of helicopters. They need just a strip, small space on land, on water body. They can also be landed over a platform in sea body. Gate, the first component of airport. The gate number is generally written on the plane ticket, and gate number is a label that tells us that which airport gate to go to board your plane. As such, in case of railways, platform number 1, 2, 3, 4, same way on airports, there are gate number. For site selection of the airport, windrows diagram is very helpful. Windrows diagram showing the wind data of last 5 to 10 years. They are presented graphically in the form of a chart. They shows direction, intensity and duration of wind. It is used to determine orientation of runway, supporting wind or wind from opposite direction. That is very crucial in orientation of runway. This is the windrows diagram in which you are finding that 0 to 360 degree is divided into 16 quadrants, 16 parts, and in particular part the wind direction is plotted along with their speed, velocity. There are mainly four types of runway. Single runway. If two strips are provided for more traffic, these are the parallel runway. If two runways are provided in this way, they are crossing runway. If two runway strips are provided in this way, that is like say open V, so these are the four patterns of runway: single runway, parallel runway, crossing runway, open V type runway. This is also V-type runway. So divergent or open V, crossing or intersecting. Runway, you are finding length of runway is design of included in design of airport. Taxiway, the landed aircraft is going to the parking area through taxiway. Same way, from one runway to another runway, it goes through taxiway. For boarding, unboarding of the passenger through taxiway, from the runway, aircraft moves. This is combination of runway and taxiway. Aircraft parking systems, patents, that is say angled nose in, angled nose out, nose in, nose out, straight and parallel. This way parking is guided, guided parking. You are finding parking at airports. Here you will find nose in, nose out type of parking. Terminal building. An airport terminal is a building at an airport. It is where passengers are able to get on and off aircraft. Inside the terminal, passengers can buy tickets, leave or pick up their luggage, and be checked by security staff. Waiting room, fresh room, duty-free shops, etc. are the facilities provided at terminal building. So you find here terminal building. Loading apron. Apron is the paved area adjacent and in front of the terminal building. It is used for loading and unloading of contents of aircrafts, minor repairing and fueling and checking of aircraft is carried out at loading apron. Boarding and unboarding of passengers is carried out at loading apron. So today in this session, we have discussed about waterways and airways, along with their advantages and limitations, their vehicles, their components, and the criteria for their design. So we have seen about quays, valves like components of the waterways. In airport, the components like loading apron, terminal building, runway and taxiway we have seen in this session. Thank you.